The U.S. Navy's F-35Cs are now getting integrated to the aircraft carriers. As per reports, the F-35Cs are going through operational tests, which include takeoff, aerial maneuvers, weapons integration, and landing on a carrier deck. The operations are being conducted along with the current set of aircraft, which includes F-18 Super Hornets, E-2D Hawkeye surveillance planes, and EA-18G Growler electronic warfare aircraft. This opens up massive new possibilities for the U.S. Navy. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why F-35C operating from American supercarriers will be a massive challenge for Russia and China. Let's get started. F-35C is meant for carrier-based operation. Compared to the F-35A and F-35B, the F-35C carrier variant features larger wings with foldable wingtip sections and bigger tail. These larger wings and tail enable much improved low-speed control needed for operation from an aircraft carrier. The aircraft is more structurally reinforced to make it rugged, keeping in view that it will operate from harsh shipboard conditions. The F-35C will also include a new technology called Joint Precision Approach and Landing Systems, or JPALS. JPALS' role is to make landing the aircraft on the carrier much easier and safe. It uses the GPS satellite navigation system to provide very accurate guidance for landing on deck. It's expected to be operational by 2019. The system also has anti-jamming technology so that it can work as intended even in the hostile battle space. The most important aspect of F-35C is its ability to bring stealth attack capability to American supercarrier. American rivals Russia and China are still a long way from deploying a proper fifth-generation stealthy fighter, let alone having any carrier-based variant. F-35Cs, with its stealth profile and 1,200 nautical mile or 2,220 kilometer range, can penetrate high-threat airspace from long ranges, enabling the aircraft carriers to operate from a safe distance. In the next 5 years, the U.S. Navy plans to acquire 60 or more of these fighters. F-35C can be armed with a variety of weapons for air-to-air and air-to-land attack missions. In stealth configuration, when it's not using any external hardpoints to carry weapons, it can be equipped with two AIM-120 air-to-air missiles and two 2,000-pound joint direct air munitions. F-35C will also be able to deploy small diameter bomb 2 going forward. It's a smart weapon having a range of 69 miles or 110 kilometers against stationary targets and 45 miles, 72 kilometers, against moving targets. The bomb uses tri-mode seeker, millimeter wave, laser, and infrared guidance to home in on targets with precision. These armaments make the F-35C a potent foe, especially since it's aided by a host of American military assets like military satellites providing real-time intelligence. The U.S. has more than 10 operational carriers. This is more than the combined of all other nations, and it must also be noted that American carriers are not just carriers, but are nuclear-powered supercarriers. This includes the Nimitz-class carrier and the new Ford-class carriers. Nimitz and Ford-class have a displacement of about 100,000 tons and have a length of 337 meters, making these warships largest in the world. Ford-class supercarriers are being built to replace some of the United States Navy's existing Nimitz-class carriers and are more efficient and future-proof. American supremacy in aircraft carrier, both in terms of quality and quantity, means it has a very strong and flexible deployable force. The F-35C will be dispersed in these carriers, and these carriers are in turn dispersed around the globe. Powered by nuclear energy, these have unlimited range, giving them the ability to be deployed to everywhere from anywhere. The carriers are equipped with a multitude of defensive weapons like RIM-7 Sea Sparrow and Phalanx CIWS, apart from being protected by their own carrier strike group, which consists of multiple destroyers, cruisers, and attack submarines. The presence of so many defensive umbrellas makes the American supercarriers one of the most well-guarded military assets in the world. Nimitz and Ford-class carry a flight group of more than 70 aircraft, including F-18 Super Hornets. The F-18 jets will complement the F-35C, in both offensive and defensive mission. These are twin-engine, supersonic, all-weather carrier-capable fourth-generation multi-role fighter aircraft. They have a payload of 7,700 kilograms, that's 17,000 pounds, and can carry ground attack weapons as well as air-to-air missiles. In a battle scenario, U.S. will be able to bring the F-35C to the battle from many different land bases and carriers, making it very hard for Russia or China to repel the onslaught. Russia and China don't have this kind of operational freedom. Russia's only aircraft carrier is out of service. To know more, check the video on the above card. China is making progress in carriers, but still has no battle-ready carrier, and also it must be noted that Chinese carriers are not as capable as the American ones.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.